Hey everybody, how's it going? I hope you're all having a lovely evening. Today I'd like to answer a question that I frequently get when I'm soldering components on the board, which is, why do the components go in a place when you do it, but they fly off the board when I do it? Why is it that you're able to have the air turned all the way up in your hot air station and the components don't just blow all off the board? The answer you'll typically get online is only half of the situation. They'll say that it's surface tension. So the solder, when it melts, has something called surface tension, which is it's going to grab the component into it so that even if you're blowing on the component, it's not going to blow it away because the surface tension keeps it in that molten, melted solder. That's only half of the story. I'd like to give you the other side of the story today, which you probably didn't notice you were doing. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to solder a component my way, and then I'm going to show you your way, and maybe you'll recognize what it is that you're doing wrong. I noticed that almost every student I've ever had that has this problem is making this mistake, and I don't see it talked about on the internet very much at all. So I'm going to go over it here. Let me just turn on my fume extractor. There we go. And I'm going to grab this little donor board over here, and I'm going to show you what I do, and then I'll show you what you do. So let's say I want to grab this capacitor over here, right, in that corner. Just to make sure the camera is, like, I'm going to keep HDR turned off for now, but I'm going to have to turn that on in a moment. So let's say I want to grab this cap. This is what I do. I'm just going to grab the cap, heat up the area, and further away, like so. And then go in on the chip like that. And then when I want to put it back, even with my hot air at 100, it just goes back like that. And I take it off and it's there. Now, obviously, that could use a little bit of flux, but again, this is just for demonstration purposes. And I'm going to do it again and I'm going to show you how I'm grabbing it from the side. This is how I'm going to grab this component. So I'm going to turn up the HDR so that you can see that a little bit better. I have two HDR there. It's going to be a little bit washed out, but no biggie, no biggie. Okay, so this is how I've grabbed the component. I'm going to zoom in on it a little bit for you. Do you see how the leg of my tweezer is not below the bottom of the component? I'm kind of 60% in. So let's say 0% is up here and then 100% is down here. I'm kind of at that, like, right about halfway mark where I've chosen to grab this particular component. Just going to turn up the HDR a little bit more for you so you can see that better. See that? So I have my tweezer is going right up to the halfway point of the component so that I have space to push it down on the board. So when I go to place a component, the component itself, it's two leads. When I say leads, I mean this end and this end, which are the metal ends, are able to make contact with the motherboard. So when I heat the solder, even though this is kind of crummy solder, and admittedly this solder really, really badly needs some flux, I can do this. I can let go of my tweezer, and the component just sits there without flying away. Now let me demonstrate what you're most likely doing if you're new. And this is one of those things that it's impossible to tell that somebody's doing this unless you actually see them do it in person. That's why I like holding these classes in person. Let's say that you actually touch the board, right? Now you see how when I move back, how the component kind of went upwards on my tweezer? Now let's see what that looks like over here. If I move it like this, hey, one sec, I hit something when I was moving it. You see how the tweezer leads are now closer to the bottom of the component? Well, as you're moving stuff around, the component itself might actually get to a point where your tweezer leads are going further into the component than the component itself. So when you do this and you think that the component is making contact with the board because you only have a 2D view, you're missing depth from this view, it's actually not making contact with the board at all. So just to exaggerate this a little bit, I'm going to move it up. And now let's try to solder this onto the board. So you're doing this. And then you heat everything up over here, right? You heat it up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You let go, and it blows away. Now, why does it blow away for you when it doesn't blow away for me? Because it was never making contact with the board. And this is a very, very common newbie mistake, which is when you are grabbing a surface mount component, they just go to grab it like me grab, and then you wind up with this. If the legs are going past the component, then it's never going to make proper contact with the board. It's going to be too high up. You want to grab a surface mount component like this. Watch. And then when you put it on your side, one moment. I'm not used to that, and I actually just stabbed myself on something on the side of the board that was sticking up. Ow. Okay, we'll just redo that for posterity. You want to grab your surface mount components like this. And I'll grab this cap over here for an example. So that when I turn it to the side, see how I'm not all the way down? There's still more than enough space when I'm putting this down for it to be making contact with the board. I want to be able to push this down and have it be flat on the board. This is also a mistake that people will make when soldering connectors onto the board. When soldering a connector on the board, you never want to have the connector sitting up like this. You want the connector to be as flat as humanly possible. It should sit on the board in a manner where even if you didn't solder it, it would conduct electricity and everything would work. That's obviously an ideal, but you want it to be pushed so hard down on the board that it, when you do your anchor pins, that if you were to just leave it like this, it would actually work without you soldering, and the soldering is just icing on the cake. You don't want to have the board be over here and then the connector kind of be sitting like this when you're doing the work. And this same thing applies if you're soldering a QFN. I'll show you a way that you can have a giant solder void when soldering a QFN if you do this. Well, let's just find a common QFN. Here we go. We got a small one over here. Just take this off for a moment. The HDR helps me out a little bit, but it really does kind of wash out the image. Yeah, I'm being too OCD here. Yeah, so that's HDR. Okay. So let's say I take this QFN off. Right? Now, I can do this, and I can heat it, and this chip is going to go right where it's supposed to. My hot air is at full heat right now. Full heat. And it still goes where it's supposed to. Now, if you grab a QFN like... The thing is, I'm grabbing it like this. And then when you look at it from the side, see that? Ah, I just dropped it because I was looking at the monitor to see what you see. Unedited, baby. See that? There's still room for me to push it on the board. Now, if you grab a QFN chip like this, like from this view, it still looks very similar, especially if you're untrained. But then when you turn it around, what the F is this? Look, see, you have... This is never going to make contact with the board like that. It has no chance of making contact with the board like that. So what you have to do... See, look what happens if I try to solder it like that. If you try to solder it like that, you get this. Ah, it's horrible. Watch. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, no. See, it's away because it was never touching the board to begin with. So you always want to make sure that you position yourself with your tweezers so that your component is actually making contact with the board. You want to give it a chance for that surface tension to actually work. The surface tension is what's going to pull the component onto its pads, but it can't be hovering above the pad for that to happen. It has to actually be making contact with the pad, and then when you take the air away, boom, just pulls it into place, and it's beautiful. So take a look in the microscope. What I want you to do is tilt it. Just take a component that you're working on and do this. Give yourself the luxury of a 3D viewing experience. Don't just look on a 2D plane. It helps you when you're learning. That's it for today. And as always, I hope you learned something. I'll see you all in the next video. Bye now.